Yo, what is up, YouTube? We are back on the Denver Dynasty, and today we're doing something different. We had a lot of updates. I made some major changes, some major moves, so I had to share it with you guys. Now, one thing I wanted to do is I wanted to get my team better, and a lot of you guys said, Berg, get a new shortstop, and I wanted a new shortstop, so I went out and I did the Ozzie Smith collection. Surprisingly enough, this collection was really, really cheap to do, man. I think it cost me around, I don't know, maybe 10K stubs. There weren't really any just crazy expensive cards. I think I had maybe one or two golds already, so I just needed to buy two more golds, and yeah, this collection 10k stubs got an Ozzie Smith, and his stats are great speed. I love speed, great fielding, all that good stuff. Okay hitter, great plate vision, but I think he should be a beast at shortstop. He was a beast on defense in real life, so I know in the game probably gonna be a beast on defense as well. So that's just really to bulk up my defense and bulk up my infield. So boom, we got Ozzie, put Ozzie at shortstop, but I wasn't done. I had to keep going, so I decided to knock out a few more collections. And next up was the Cleveland Indians collection, so I get this Kenny Lofton. Kenny Lofton, kind of like Ozzie Smith, super duper fast, 90 speed, great fielding, 95 fielding, and he's really good at bat too. 86 contact versus right, 91 plate vision, not a lot of power, but contact, ground balls, get on base, get around the bases, and he's a great base runner too, so I thought he would be a great pickup. Now this collection, I thought it would be a little cheaper, but some of these silvers go for like 2K, 3K a pop. You definitely might want to try and knock this one out during a promo, when maybe it's some expensive ass packs, because right now there isn't a single gold that goes into this collection, so of course the silver is going to be a bit much. I think these three silvers right here probably costed the most. I once again, right around 2K, 3K a pop, and this collection ran me about, I think about 12K stuff. Right now, our team overall is up to an 87, and since the collections were so easy and so cheap, a lot cheaper than I expected, I said I'm going to do another collection just so I could have a legendary outfield. And this time, I knocked out the Miami Marlins collection, and this one, once again, pretty cheap, all silver collection, pretty cheap collection. I think it ran me about 8K, 7K, very cheap collection to do. Of course, I already had some of the cards, but super cheap collection. And of course, by doing it, we got a Cliff Floyd. Now guys, Cliff Floyd, I'm not sure if I should start him, because Sterling Marte has been a beast. Like, he's been a stud for us, great fielding, even better at bat. Like, he's been super good for the team. So Cliff Floyd, if you guys think we should start him, let me know. Honestly, I think it might have been a mistake doing his collection, because I don't really have a place for him on the team, you know? I think Sterling Marte is the much better player to me. I keep saying his name wrong, but Sterling Marte is better at fielding. He's better at base running than at bat. He gets his homers, man. I've gotten homers with him, so I can't really complain about his batting. Cliff Floyd, up on the other hand, I haven't played with him, so I guess I'll get a game with him for sure, but I think, honestly, he might have been a mistake, but since we already got him and can't sell him, I might have to sell Sterling Marte. Marte is so weird to say, but anyways, continue with the lineup update. So I was feeling froggy. I had some legends, new players to show you guys. So then I said, okay, let's work the marketplace. Let's sell some stuff, make some stuff. So I started going through my cards, my players, and I guess my binders, you could say. And pretty much, I was just selling my dupes and golds that I wasn't using. And I came across this guy, Glenn freaking Perkins. 14K, 15K freaking stubs. Had to sell him instantly. Wasn't using him. The guy wasn't in my rotation at all, so I had to sell him. And that was a quick 14K stubs. Then I was feeling, I was like, you know what? New stubs, new players, things are kind of going our way, let's get some packs. And I bought some packs, and these packs, man, my show packs are so bad. I said, okay, I'm not going to record this because I know I'm not going to get anything, but just in case, I'm gonna flip for the Elgato. And as expected, packs were ass, getting a lot of commons. The thing I hate about commons is some of the legendary cards have white borders like commons, so even if you see a bunch of white borders, it could be something good, but not for me, just a bunch of commons, bunch of bronzes, bunch of ass packs. Then this next pack, I come across the unthinkable, and I see a glimmer of blue. I see a flicker of blue, and yo, I knew what it was. I knew it was a diamond, and man, yo, I was so gassed when I pulled this. I wish I could have did it live. I was so gassed when I got it, but I knew it was a diamond. I had to stop and breathe for a second. Finally pulled it. Finally checked it out. Got a Stanton, dude's a beast, and another outfielder. So this video alone, we got three new freaking outfielders, all legendary or diamond, so that's pretty dope. Now, honestly, guys, with Stanton, I don't know if we should keep him or sell him. His fielding is okay. He's a pretty slow, pretty lousy base runner, but his hitting is amazing. Amazing hitting. 98 power versus right, 97 power versus left. Plate vision only at 39. That's not too great. 88 contact versus right, 88 contact. Yo, just an amazing hitter. Great athlete, solid fielder, lousy base runner. I don't know if we should keep him or sell him. I'm going to get at least one game in with him, but if you guys think we should keep him or sell him, let me know. Also, with Stanton, what do I do with my lineup? Because my outfield is fine like this, but I guess I could plug in Stanton at right field and plug in Deion at left field, or I could plug in Deion somewhere else. Because Deion, if you don't know, is a 99 everywhere on the freaking baseball field. So yeah, just let me know what you guys think we should do with Stanton and where I should play Deion if I put Stanton at right field. Where should I place Deion? Because to me, the team's great. Yo, Bagwell, Ozzie Smith, Altuve, maybe run Deion at catcher. But I really like Luke Roy too, so I don't know, man. I don't know. Just help your boy out in the comments. And yeah, that is it, man. Quick video. I just had to update you guys on these moves I pulled today, because I was low-key kind of impressed with myself, kind of proud of these moves. Then we got super lucky with the packs, that I was super dope. I had to share that. I have some more show gameplay coming out very, very soon. And yeah, I will see you guys in the next one. Take it easy.